fellow countrymen, men and women of the Gambian Armed Forces, it has been over 20 years since Yahya Jammeh forced himself into power following the military takeover on July 22, 1994, and later became the president of the Gambia. Since this pathetic event, you have seen apparent infrastructural developments such as Arc 22, Banjul International Airport, the creation of our only TV station, GRTS, etc. But also there was at the same time a social regression. In our army, he attempted to restructure it by promotion countless officers from lower to higher ranks, up to the rank of Lieutenant General whilst doing this promotion. Yahya Jammeh would often say that promotion are by merit. As you all are aware now, you will sincerely agree with me that this is unfounded. Instead, he conducts this mass promotion for officers who are prepared to carry out these dirty jobs in place of shaping the army into one of the best in the sub-region. For a professional army, it defends the territorial integrity of the state, but for Yahya Jammeh, the military must be loyal to him, utilizing many officers to commit atrocities like the torturing of political opponents, summary execution, disappearance without trace, extrajudicial assassination, just to name a few. He continually meets out these punishments across the board, and even the army is not spared. This mode of attitude by Yahya Jammeh is simply just meant to instill fear among you in order to consolidate his power. In his decide and rule style, any officer who refuses to carry out his special tortures and other punishments against our citizens, you are demoted as soon as possible. That's why time and again, you will see officers, for example, demoted from brigadier general to colonel or even private. You can observe also in the army, you will have class of superiority. For instance, the state guards personnel are more preferable to the president than the military personnel of Yundum barracks. With all this wrong attitude of the army, you will leave to rule the country. Do you still leave him to rule the country? It's a question. Officers of Gambia Armed Forces, do you accept Yahya Jammeh to develop you into the best institution for the professional promotion of the army? Therefore, you have a moral duty to serve and protect the physical integrity of your citizens and to restore the real values of the Gambia Armed Forces. That's why I would like to express you my hope and belief in all of you as members of Gambia Armed Forces to act now. Regarding the rescue of our nation from this tyrant and selfish commander-in-chief of the Gambia Armed Forces, Yahya Jammeh, I, Cheikh Sidi Abayo, leader of the National Transitional Council for the Gambia, NTCG, and member of the new coalition, Wato Sita, guarantee any officers, security groups, or senior officers of Gambia Armed Forces and other security apparatus interested to come and join the struggle to dislodge Yahya Jammeh and his criminal regime from power. You will be protected by the international institution and jurisdiction such as the International Criminal Court, the ICC. After the fall of Yahya Jammeh, this is imminent, and Yahya Jammeh will not survive it too long. The army and the civilians must be united to confront Yahya Jammeh, but the Gambia Armed Forces should be the godfather of our popular uprising, akin to what happened in Cairo, Egypt, and the rest of the Arab Spring. If they can, we as a nation also can. The Gambia Armed Forces will play a key role during this transitional period, and the transitional government will facilitate a welfare for the families of the officers and senior officers involved. Finally, I request each and every officer or senior officers interested to rally behind the protesters for a mass protest to be launched in the coming days from the National Assembly to end Jammeh's wish to become king of the Gambia and to secure their protest for our final victory. I am fully ready to conduct this chapter of our history to liberate our motherland, the Gambia, and to restore justice and our freedom once and for all. Glory be to Watosita, glory be to the Gambia.